So, Mike, let's get to an email question from one of our listeners, this one from Dan, who asks, I think, an important question as we get into the summer months here. And Dan asks, while I'm sure it's possible to contract the virus outdoors, is there anything about respiratory transmission or the virus itself that would make outdoor transmission less likely? Does an outdoor gathering, like an afternoon barbecue, pose a significant outbreak risk if there's an asymptomatic person in attendance?
Good news this week. Not surprising. There was a study that was released out of China in which they evaluated more than 300 outbreak clusters of COVID-19, looking at people who were all exposed to one individual. And in these outbreaks, they varied in terms of three or more people at an event, including more than 1,245 cases. And they found that only in one instance, and even this one, it's not clear how they found this because it was only two cases, occurred where the contact was actually outside. All the rest of them were inside. Now, I do have to say there is some challenge with that because it occurred during the winter when the Hubei province outbreak was most prominent and it was colder. So people may have spent more time inside had they been outside. But I think the data generally support what we've been saying all along is that the aerosols that one creates and even the droplets dissipate much more quickly outside. Any air movement moves them, and that the chances of time and exposure, meaning that how much virus is someone excreting, how close you're to that virus, and how much time you spend, because you do have to have an infectious dose acquired there, is such that being outside and walking, moving, probably poses a very, very small limited risk. And if there was ever a time that we as a country would like to get our sea legs under us again, it's now. The spring is here, moving into summer. And so I strongly encourage that people do get outdoor activity, but not in large crowds. Again, I would say walking, in parks, in locations where you're not cheek to jowl with someone is one of the best things you could do. And I think that the risk is incredibly low for those kinds of events. So everybody on this podcast, start getting your walking shoes on, stay healthy, walk. And when you're outside, avoid crowds, avoid people being all congregated together as much as you can. But even then, the outdoors surely does provide us with a buffer there as these aerosols and droplets dissipate much more quickly. They move quickly with any air movement, which we're more likely to see outdoors.